Chris Jenuck here, Insight Media VueReal booth here at Display Week, taking a look at their microLED devices. First things I want to show are these two small ones here. You can actually see the image a lot better in the reflection back here. That's blue. Over here is the green. These are available in red, green, and blue. All of MicroView's devices are RGB, so discrete devices, and they're kind of positioned in the market as they use solid printing technology, so it's a very proprietary transfer technology. These particular ones are passive matrix based. They use very tiny 10 micron flip chip devices on a 35 micron pixel pitch, so very small, 160 by 120 each, and a 0.4 inch diagonal. That's what this is, 0.4 inch diagonal. So this is kind of an application here would be, information snacking, maybe a sports goggle, things like that. This is a transparent active matrix device now. So this is LTPS on glass, about 172 ppi, 80% transmissivity, about third. I think these are about 150 micron pixel pitch. This was actually used by a tier one OEM at CES in one of their demos. I can't really name the customer at this point. Moving down the line here, this is now a passive matrix device, 2.1 passive matrix device, RGB, 30 by 45 flip chip microLEDs in this guy. And they have the separate drivers, of course, chip on film drivers in the back with a Tcon. This is a dimmer now at about 300 nits. I'm not sure what this one is, but it's probably 500 or so. Moving down the line, we've got red, green, and blue. Now, these are, wow, two micron size micro emitters, so very small. But now you move to a vertical micro LED. So with a flip chip, the contacts are both on the bottom, so it makes for easy mounting. With a vertical micro LED, you have one contact on top, one contact on the bottom. The reason you might want to do that is if you want to go down to really, really small devices. So at 2 microns, for example, it gets really hard to do flip chip devices. Now, the disadvantage of vertical is you have to do some post-processing to make contact on the upper part of the LED. You need two contacts, of course. It's a diode. So you have to do some a metallization layer and electrodes to make contacts on the top. If it's a transparent electrode, then you can get the emission from the whole surface. If it's not, you're losing some emission surface area. Flip chip, you can get the whole surface to emit, of course. So what's kind of interesting, this is also a 0.7 inch device. And the way they want to use things like this, they have a patent on this. And for an AR application, this is what you can do. So if you look at this diagram, each of these devices here, these are the displays. So this is very similar to a combiner for a DLP engine, for example. In a DLP engine, these would be just LEDs, just bright red, green, and blue LEDs. And they go into this combiner, and you get a light out that goes to the DLP engine. In this case, instead of just LEDs, there's actually imagers. So you can combine these to create a very compact way of creating a full-color display. And this is extendable. You could have a deep blue and a light blue. You could have a sensor. You could have cyan. You could do lots of different things with this architecture. So it's pretty cool.